I'd like to thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for being with me tonight. And for the music, I'd like to thank Mr. Nelson Riddle.
This is Jonathan Schwartz with Nelson Riddle. There's that organ. Now, Nelson, one day in 1966, I brought home a new Sinatra album built around the hit single Strangers in the Night, and on came the second song on the first side, which happened to be The Summer Wind.
The summer wind came blowing in from across the sea.
And to my astonishment, an organ. And then as I heard the album, I realized the job that the organ was doing for you. And since that time, since that album, that's the first time I ever heard you use an organ. How did it come to be? In your mind, what role does an organ play?
Does the name Wild Bill Davis mean anything to me?
Oh, of course.
One of the people I'm working with in New Jersey, it sounds like I'm at a gym out there working out with people. Not so. I could use it, but not necessarily working out with Betty Hutton. But I worked with her in Atlantic City in 1954. And Jimmy Rolls was her piano player at the time. And Jimmy and I went to a bar one night, and we listened to Wild Bill Davis. And I was fascinated by his work. And then later on, I heard some of the work of a Los Angeles organist named Jimmy Smith. And somewhere along the line, I decided to use the organ with Frank, and then no one had ever done it up to that time.
But not until 1966, 12 years after your visit to the bar with Jimmy Rolls.
That's right.
12 years.
That's right, yeah. And I like it very much.
What did he think about when he came into the studio and saw an organ?
He seemed pleased. Sometimes a sign of pleasure was no sign of displeasure.
To the Gershwin songbook now with Ella. This is a remarkable arrangement. It's so powerful and specific and dramatic and perfect for Ella.
It's wonderful. It's marvelous. You should care for me.
The Gershwin Songbook. 53 songs and Ella. How long did it take and what do you feel about the project?
It started in January 59 and ended in August 59, several sessions. I think there were, as you said, 59 sides. 53 plus six instrumental sides.
Right.
59, and someone, I think it was Lou Levy, wore a Patek Philippe watch home from Switzerland, which was presented to me at the end of the last date, and it was my treasured possession until I came to New York in 1978 with my two younger girls. They tried to teach me how to disco. It was a disaster, but I got very warm in the process, and the poor Patek Philippe had been suspended from my wrist by a then worn out watch band, a leather one, and it dropped and I lost it.
It's magnifique. It's what I seek. You should care for.
My impression of the musical part of the project was that I think it was a good idea that the dates were spaced because it enabled me to come up with different ideas for each song.
I got rhythm. I got music.
Andre Previn took occasion to listen to it and was impressed by it. And I think partly from that came his support of me in certain critical instances. For instance, I became the conductor of the Julie Andrews television show on his recommendation, and later on inherited the picture The Great Gatsby on his recommendation. Andre was and is and will be a very powerful figure in musical circles, and if you have his support, why, you've really got something very precious.
I got rhythm. I got music, I got daisies in green pastures, I got starlight, I got sweet dreams, I got my man. Who can ask us for anything